Next, two takes on AIDS today, here and around the world. We begin with a global progress report, more than three decades after the first cases were reported. Gwen Ifill has that.
When researchers, political leaders, and advocates gather in Washington next week for the world's largest AIDS meeting, there will be something new on the agenda: optimism. AIDS deaths have declined, the rate of new infections among children is falling, and more than 8 million people in poor and middle-income countries are receiving crucial life-saving drugs. But the global picture remains grim. Worldwide, more than 34 million people have HIV, 23 million of them in sub-Saharan Africa. Last year, 1.7 million people died from the disease, and millions still can't get the drugs they need. Michel Sidibe is the executive director of UNAIDS, which just issued the latest report on all this, and he joins me now. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you very much.
The new numbers, do they show that we're turning the tide in this crisis?
You know, I think we are breaking the backbone of this epidemic. It is the first time that we can say that we have 56 countries worldwide who stabilize, even reduce significantly the number of new infections. We are seeing also prevention revolution working. Young people taking their responsibility, changing their behavior. And we are seeing reduction by almost 25% amongst those young people, even 50% in countries like South Africa, which is just showing that we are going to win if we remain committed to this mobilization of resources to fight this epidemic.
What do we think is behind this? Is it a change, as you said, in behavior, young people realizing or others realizing what they should and shouldn't do? Or is it access to medication, access to care?
I think it's many factors. First of all, let me say that the compassion and the mobilization of American taxpayers have been producing results. You have been able to put resources out there when people were not thinking at all that we could even put people on treatment. 10 years ago, it was $15,000 per person per year. But because you believed that we need to save life, and you did it, and today we are seeing results. But also we are seeing President Obama's full commitment to make sure that we can come with a new narrative, which is about sharing responsibility, making sure that we sustain our gain, and that is also starting to pay off.
But that's what the U.S. is doing to help. What about what these nations, especially in sub-Saharan Africa, are willing to do for themselves? 10 years ago, Thabo Mbeki from South Africa wouldn't even admit that, that the HIV virus caused AIDS. Is that changing?
That changed. I think UNAIDS try to work with African countries. Today, we can say that we have almost 33 countries in Africa, 33 countries. We have been able to increase their domestic investment by 50% during the last 5 years. South Africa, very good example, just last year put $2 billion to fight the HIV in South Africa. We would have never believed on that one. And today, we are seeing that happening also in emerging nations. We have been working with China, India, Brazil, Russia, all of those countries today, instead waiting for resources coming from Global Fund or paying for their AIDS response, but which is the change.
But let me ask you a little bit more about something other than money, which is this question. For a long time, there was a stigma against the people who disproportionately suffer from HIV, which is to say drug abusers and homosexuals and prostitutes and people who no self-respecting African leader wanted to stand on a stage with. Has that changed?
I think what is very frustrating me is not just in Africa, in Russia, in Central Asia, in different parts of the world. We are seeing, unfortunately, that universal access for most at-risk population, the man who having sex with man, people who inject drugs, or a sex worker, are denied from their access to services. They have to hide themselves. They have to go underground, and which is not helping us. You can imagine, for example, in the last 10 years, we had almost 250% increase on new infection in Eastern Europe and Central Asia.
And have costs dropped also? When you say access and you say that many countries have stepped up and helped with this. Has it become less expensive now to get that care?
Yes. 10 years ago, like I was saying, we're talking about almost $15,000 per person per year. Today, we are talking about less than $100 per person per year. And that changed completely the dynamic of the response. Today, we are having 8 million people on treatment. Because we have been able also to create this enabling environment, which help us to deal with trade issues, but also to deal with services, the cost of providing services.
As the head of UNAIDS, you can look back at what's happened in the last 10 years. Look forward for a moment to what should be happening, what you would like to see occur in the next 10 years.
I think for me it's very clear. It's a vision of 3-0, zero new infections, zero death due to HIV, and zero discrimination. Because when we discriminate, it's our decision to discriminate. You know, I personally believe that this 0-0 is about social justice, is about redistribution of opportunities, is about making sure that what we are building is inclusive. And I believe that is the only way we can have stability in many parts of the world. And AIDS can be an entry point for really reforming the global health response.
Michel Sidibe, Executive Director of UNAIDS, thank you so much for joining
us. Thank you very much. It was a pleasure.